Am I the asshole for sending my mother to prison? My mother is in prison for defrauding the government for 10 plus years, which finally caught with her. About 2 years ago, I was subpoenaed by the court to testify and ended up being the testimonial that ultimately sent her to federal prison. She has been in prison for just over a year now. As a result, we are estranged. However, I wasn't given much of a choice because my current profession has strict legal requirements that I can't risk bending or I'll lose everything. Fast forward to this past week. My maternal grandfather passed away suddenly from complications from a stroke he had 2 months ago. Everyone is sad and devastated, and it's been hard to reconcile the loss during COVID-19. A lot of prisons will grant furlough for those who wish to attend their loved one's funeral, something we already had to do back in February when my grandmother passed away. And I was the one who filled out the paperwork and was 100% responsible for my mother during her furlough. So once I received news of my grandfather's passing, I started on the paperwork but stopped because it turned out that my grandfather is going straight to cremation without a funeral or service, because that is what my grandfather wanted. And I told my family that we weren't furloughing my mother out because of the fact there is no service or funeral. My family understood. Fast forward to today, when my sibling calls me to thank me for furloughing our mom out. Shocked and confused, I ask the obvious, what do you mean? Turns out, as I discovered by calling the prison, that my aunt busted my mother out of prison on falsified documents where they forged my signature and gave my contact information. And told the prison that there was a funeral and that my mother's presence was required. 1. I live in a separate province. 2. There isn't a funeral or service. There is absolutely no reason for her to be outside of prison during a pandemic. Especially when prisons are COVID-19 hotspots. So I had to call the police because if caught, I could lose my livelihood, my license and a career I love. After all, my mother didn't want to grieve in prison and has zero regards for anyone else's health and well-being. I texted everyone in my family to encourage my aunt to my mother back to prison, or I would have no choice but to call the police and charge my aunt with identity theft and have a warrant issued for my mother. Something I really don't want to do. However, my family is calling me an insensitive asshole for not allowing the family to get together to grieve, because I can't be there and I'm taking it out on them. So I called my aunt directly and recorded the call and told her if she didn't return my mother to prison by noon tomorrow, I would call the police and have them issue a warrant for my mother and have her charged with identity theft. Am I the asshole for not allowing my family for using me to basically prison break my mother? Edit. No funeral. I double-checked with G-father's partner. EDIT2. Called police. Police confirm I will not face legal repercussions as I am a victim. Update. Spoke to my lawyer and asked how it was possible for my aunt to pick up my mother from prison. Turns out, due to the pandemic, visitors are a no-no. In my case, inmates who are furloughed go through all the steps to leave, but the family members are outside waiting. And on a page, I did not see originally, they had my aunt's address as a potential address for my mother to stay, but it was put as a secondary, not as a primary. So I guess the ball was severely dropped, but I won't have definitive answers till I call on Monday. Update 2. Yal, please stop assuming my brother is going to prison. He is a lot of things, but he wouldn't help my mother or aunt with this jailbreak. If anything, he is a grief-stricken victim who just wanted to see his mom for the first time since the pandemic and be sad about our grandfather. Who is also currently being an asshole, because he feels I should let them all grieve. It's a fucked up situation, but my brother did nothing illegal. Calm down.
Not the asshole. Please stop giving these people chances. Call the police, report the identity theft and let the cops go after whoever. This is not your fault and the longer you hesitate and give chances and worry you're an asshole, the more likely it is that this will ruin your life. Not the asshole, but call the police prison now and report it. Without the prison knowing what happened, what will stop them from doing something similar again and just telling everyone not to tell you? Don't risk it.
Not the asshole, and you should turn your aunt in, regardless. She stole your identity, forged your signature, and potentially mixed your name up in a prisoner escape. No way. She should be sharing a cell with your mother.
Not the asshole, maybe your mother and identity stealing aunt can be cellmates.
My first assumption is that there is in fact a funeral, they just don't want you to go to it. Not only are you not the asshole, I'm concerned that warning them makes you complicit. But even if nothing happens, what if she escapes the country?
Not the asshole. Why didn't your aunt just furlough your sister herself? Why did she forge your name? That's just asking for it. Stop giving them chances and turn them in immediately before you get caught knowingly letting them do this.
Not the asshole. Wow, what an absolute cluster F, CK this is. You're in a hard situation, but it's not of your making. If you didn't take these steps, then if it gets found out, not only would they be in trouble but you as well.
Not the asshole. You weren't the one breaking the law. She forged the paperwork. Play stupid games, win stupid prizes.
Not the asshole. I'm sorry for your loss. Your mom has repeatedly broken the law for selfish reasons, without any regard for your well-being, and now your aunt has joined her and once again put you at risk. I'm really sorry you have to deal with their horrific behavior on top of mourning your grandfather's passing. Not the asshole. Your aunt is literally committing a crime, and involving your livelihood in it. Anyone in your family that is on her side about this are, in my opinion, delusional.
Not the asshole. It was insensitive of your family forever putting you in that position, your mother included. Don't feel bad at all. Honestly, stay away from them. Not the asshole. How did a prison just let a prisoner leave on falsified documents? If they granted her furlough using your aunt's info, I don't think you would care or actively seek to get involved upon learning of her temp release. The problem is they used your identity.
Mom, I can cheat the government. Oops, I am sent to jail. Child, I need integrity or my job flies away. Mom's other kids, let's just get her out of jail on furlough, cause. Op is not the asshole. For further misunderstanding of this study are, raised by narcissists.
Not the asshole, they stole your fucking identity and put your career in danger.
Holy heck, not the asshole op def. Not the asshole, your family, particularly your aunt, should know falsifying a document is illegal. They are compromising your career doing this. To call you an insensitive a-hole really tells me your family doesn't care for your career and future endeavors. They should know what they are doing right now is illegal.
Mum, is convicted for fraud. Also mum, with aunt, commits more fraud. Op, did I do something wrong? And #X200B. Op, not the asshole. Clearly not the asshole.
Oh gosh, I have so many fears of my mill trying to pull something like this in attempts to trick my husband and I into meeting with his father. He went to jail for child abuse and for some godawful reason she is still in contact with him and visits him. She is always getting pissy with my husband when he says he wants absolutely nothing to do with the man and she's already tried to trick us into seeing him. Not the asshole, and calling the police on both of them is definitely the right choice. And if your family wants to bitch about it, one of them can take over any and all paperwork related to your mother from now on. Let them take the fall since they seem to have such problems with it, not you.
Not the asshole. That is literally insane on so many levels and really scary considering. Not the asshole. Your mom chose to break the law and now your family is choosing to break the law while using your name.
Not the asshole. Please keep us updated and keep yourself safe.
Not the asshole. Just wondering, if they used your identity to get her out on falsified records, wouldn't they require you to be the one to pick her up? Why would they release her to someone that wasn't on the dock? You didn't send your mother to jail. Your mother got herself imprisoned by breaking the law.
Not the asshole. It's so abusive and you shouldn't have to sacrifice your livelihood for abusive people willing to steal your identity to jailbreak.
Not the asshole, what a bad situation.
Not the asshole, your family shouldn't have falsified documents.
Not the asshole. Don't let your family put your career at risk. They aren't worth it.
Not the asshole. Hope you're recording all your calls including 3 ones with cops now. Thanks for all the updates. Sorry you're stuck in such a mess.
Not the asshole. Protect yourself.
I need an update, dude.
I understand that you don't want to get in any trouble, but it sounds like you really want your mom in jail. If she hurt someone, sure, but for defrauding the government. My dad had to do some time a few years ago and I wouldn't wish that on anyone unless they did something truly horrible. It changed who he was because they strip you off your humanity. So, unless there's a lot more to the story, you're the asshole.
Not the asshole. I'm so sorry your mom and aunt suck.
Not the asshole. 1. Your mom did the crime, not you. 2. Your mom and family think that them committing another crime and grieving together is worth it, you losing your career. Unless the prison your mom was in is a torturous hellhole, I don't see any justifiable reason why she should be broken out of jail, especially with your job on the line. Man, obviously not the asshole. But I feel kinship for you. My mother has never been caught committing fraud. I have suspicions about things she did when I was a kid, but no proof. I complete fraud investigatory work as a part of my career. Earlier this year, when my fiancé was furloughed, he applied for our unemployment benefits. But due to my earnings, savings, he wasn't eligible. Mum's response: he shouldn't have told them you were in a relationship. Should have just said you were housemates. Sigh. Yes, Mum, because committing welfare fraud is exactly what I should do considering my job. Face with rolling eyes.
Not the asshole. You should not wait to call the police. You could be risking your profession.
Not the asshole. These people are bound and determined to take you down in one way or another. First putting you in a situation they created and making you go to court, then stealing your identity to get her out of jail. And then after that, once you did the proper course of your own protection and safety, not that give a damn, they have the balls to tell you, dot, you were wrong in doing so. Turn your mother and aunt both in. If your aunt did this once, I have a feeling she and anyone else would try and do this again. It is not worth the risk.
Not the asshole. They did this, not you.
Not the asshole. If you don't mind, PLZ, give us an update.
Not the asshole. Good grief, she never learns, does she?
Not the asshole. On top of all that, I would suggest that you contact credit agencies and check to see that her mother and aunt have not opened accounts in your name. If they're willing to fraudulently sign for a furlough, they may have figured that they can get some free money as well.
Not the asshole. Forgery, fraud, endangering your credentials and livelihood. Hi, Dad. I'm in jail. I like it here. I'm gonna stay.
Not the asshole. So I had to call the police because if caught, I could lose my livelihood, my license and a career I love. The only reason you need.
Not the asshole. But just popped in here to say lawyer up now. Since you've called the police already, time to call the lawyer next. You don't want to get caught with your pants down in this situation. They're going to want answers, so you're going to want to have a lawyer at the ready just in case. You're an insensitive asshole for objecting to having your signature forged and your entire career threatened. No, not the asshole.
NTA. Not the asshole. Cut them off from your life. To be honest, I don't think this is a real story, but if it is, YTA for not furloughing your mother. They would have let her out for a memorial organized by the family even if your grandfather didn't want a funeral. That seems to be more or less what they are doing, as they said they wanted grieve together. NTA for turning them in. I don't see why your aunt could have just put her name down.
Definitely not the asshole.
Not the asshole. Your mother and aunt made stupid choices, leaving you without one. I'm going to go with not the asshole. And for all the people getting bent out of shape and calling op the aw, would you feel that way if her mother's initial crime had been something other than fraud? What if it had been a violent crime? Not the asshole. I would also sue your aunt civilly, as she could have caused your professional body revoke your credentials. With any luck, both your mother and aunt can share a cell.